Why do you have to breathe in through your nose and out through your nose? If you breathe in through your nose and out through your mouth, you lose moisture. So there's a 42% greater water loss by breathing in through your nose and out through the mouth. Here's your nose. This is your nasal cavity. Of course, here's your nostrils. Here's your hard palate, your soft palate, your airway. Your nose warms incoming air and your nose moistens incoming air on the way in. This is very good. This helps oxygen transfer take place. This prevents exercise-induced asthma. If you breathe in cold, dry air in through your mouth, your airways are going to get aggravated. Yeah? But on the breath out, this is energy from the body. And your nose is designed to trap that moisture and to trap that warmth. And by doing that, it keeps the nose open. So the nose opens itself by breathing in and out through the nose. If you breathe in through the nose and out through the mouth, the nose is more likely to get congested. Somebody with nasal congestion, if they keep breathing through their nose will work. But they don't, because their nose feels stuffy, so they open their mouth, and then when they open their mouth, that's it. Big problem. And you'll go to your doctor. I had somebody during the week, 3 nasal surgeries, flicks a nose for the rest of her life, in her 60s, mouth breathing. She did all the surgeries, did all the nasal procedures. Nobody told her to breathe through her nose. And that's what happens. Honestly, I did the same. I had my nose done in 1994. Not plastic surgery, turbinate reduction, or whatever they did inside the nose. But I was never told to breathe through it. We have kids doing tonsillectomy and adenoidectomy by the thousands. Nobody is telling these kids breathe through it afterwards. It's terrible. Christian Giemann, who discovered sleep apnea back in the 1970s, he said that sleep disorder breathing is going to come back in these kids within 3 years of the procedure, unless nose breathing is restored. Can you imagine an ENT doing a surgery on an individual but not telling these people to breathe through their nose? It's like somebody having a broken leg. They go in, they get surgery, but after surgery, what do? Rehabilitation. They go to their physiotherapist. Their physiotherapist gives them exercises to get the muscles working again. We need to do rehabilitation and breathing. So my point is, any of you who have nasal operations and things like that, make sure you breathe through your nose. In and out, by the way, in and out. Increased water and energy loss by breathing through the mouth could be a contributing factor in these patients with nasal obstruction.